I invite you to place one or two hands on the heart space to presence this moment in time, to sync energies, realities, consciousness, ideas, and what's possible here and now, wherever, however you are. Inhale deeply. Exhale completely. Blink your eyes. Mobilize. You have 1 mindful minute of movement. I'm going to do my movement with my air element Kochi chime. Thank you. Community breath in. Community breath out. Here we are. Hey, everyone. I'm Robert Halley, performing artist, creative wellness coach based just north of Toronto. And I welcome you to the Wellness Wheel of Fortune. This series segment has been on pause because I could not travel with this. Yeah, the last time we did this was in December, and it's been refreshed with different things that will happen, which I will announce after we acknowledge those that want to be acknowledged. Because there's no me without you. Remember, the future of health and wealth is community. Community care. We all have something to offer, and we help with that accountability when we show up. So thank you for showing up. I will zip through some of those that are here. Michaela in Romania. This is incredible all around the world. About four, creativity, dancing, and overtoning. Overtoning as in vocal toning. If there's something else called overtoning, I'd be curious to know that. Yay, Gopi's hanging out, even though it's late in Australia. But hopefully this is some entertainment and ideas for you. Water cloth. I don't know what a water cloth is. You mean like some hot water in a cloth and you put it on your face or something? Because the other water cloth, when you wet a cloth, you wind it and you like beat someone. That's another type of situation. It's okay. You can manifest it here and now. You mean the water scroll. A cloth is like some wet water fetish situation. Scroll, not cloth. It's not a cloth. Dear Lord, Mira's in Egypt. Everyone thinks I'm Egyptian. I love that you're here. That is incredible. My friend just came back from Egypt. I personally did not have a good time in Egypt. I got scammed in Sharm el-Sheikh, tourist trap. But one day I'll go back. I do have a local Canadian Egyptian friend, so. 10! Meditation, breathwork, dancing. Bravo on that being a habit, a ritual, or active in your life. Hey, Liz in Toronto. Sadie in the UK. Look at this, global family, what? 7, and yoga is definitely an interesting ritual. There's so many traditions, things you can do. About an 8 and 3 when you dance. Maybe we'll dance today. We'll see what the wellness wheel offers us. Yes, we've reborn the wellness wheel, and I'll give a little description about what's going to happen in a moment. Dear Kate in New York. Hello. I used to live there. I will be visiting in July. If you want to hang out in Central Park with our New York folks. I'll have to hear about that story later. Gopi. All right, everyone. Thanks for sharing. What's my story? Creative. I would say a 7. Yeah, 7. I've been writing and doing more admin lately, but I always feel like a creative kaleidoscope. But I always float 7, 10, 7, 10. And a creative ritual or holistic habit. Well, I made the effort to schedule time to write a poem every week. And I really want that to stick and to stay. So that's a new habit. All right. So what's the story? The story is, here we are, and it's exciting. So it's been revamped. If you haven't been to the Wellness Wheel, you are going to tell me, depending, we'll figure out a way for you to decide if you're spinning. And then when it's your turn, you tell me gentle, medium, or strong. And then I'll spin it for you. And if you want to go right or left. And it's been updated. So these are what the numbers mean. Half of them are similar, but half of them are new. Because as a creative wellness coach, this is what's alive and active for me. So if you land on one, that means we do nothing. Ha ha ha. Literally, do nothing. Stare at a wall. I'm going to lie in my hammock. Nothing. In this world of overstimulation, doing nothing is better than something. If you land on two, that's movement mirroring. A song, movement meditation, you just follow my lead. Three, that's an oracle reading from the Wellness Oracle. Four, Wellness Oracle practice. So you'll pick a card and then we'll do the practice, a holistic practice. Five, powerful question. There's hundreds of questions waiting for your wisdom and your answer. Hundreds of questions. Six is movement and massage. So I'll have a dance party or whatever I want to do movement-wise, and then we'll massage something. Seven, vocal toning. Vocal toning. We'll see what we're meant to say. Eight, you get an Osho parable reading. Nine, guided drawing. We'll draw. I'll give you a guided script. And 10, ooh, I just realized something. I just remembered the one that I wanted to do, so I have to delete one of these. 10 was choreography, which I want to keep because movement arts is my forte. I need to delete one because I really want to do the dice. Let me take 5 mindful breaths. I might change this up. Michaela, 8 is Osho. Osho parable storytelling. This is challenging, actually. Maybe you can help me out. Let's make this, you're my community, right? Should we get rid of nothing? Maybe get rid of nothing. So basically I have these dice, there's pictures on them. And in my virtual membership, in my other community, every Tuesday we roll these dice and then I make up a meditation. That's so capitalist though, Gopi, to get rid of nothing. I agree, Michaela. We ain't getting rid of nothing. It's capitalist mindset that you always have to do something. And I've been depressed this week actually about that. It's like, why when I wake up, am I feeling less than because I'm not making money today or I'm not being productive? We weren't created to be go, 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 go. Like, why can't I stare at the wall and drink tea for 2 hours? We're not getting rid of nothing. So which one should we get rid of? Any ideas? Let's just take a minute and see. Because the dice meditation is really interesting. Choreography. We have two dance ones. Maybe six. We don't need to massage ourselves. We'll get rid of six. I decided. Yeah. And you know what? The massage is in the wellness oracle. So we might pull the oracle and get a massage card. So, yep. So six is picture dice. Thank you. Fantabuloso. So today is what? What day is it today? Yes, power of the group. Woo! I always forget what day it is. It is the 27th. 7 + 2, 9 + 5, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. Great. So we honor the numerology of the day for who gets to spin. 21, 2 plus 1 is 3. The third person that puts an emoji in, you'll be spinning first. Who's it gonna be? Michaela, what? You are the one. Michaela, are we going to the right or to the left? And do you want strong, medium, or gentle? And force. Left or right, strong, medium, or gentle? Fantastic. Alkaline. Woo! Da-da-da, this is not the official song. Still, it's still in development. Da-da-da, da-da-da, da-da-da. To the left. It might look to the right for you, but I'm honoring the left because this is the reality. Da-da-da. In 3, 2, 1, may what's highest and best come through for us today in this collective group with our creative wellness. 1, 2, medium. 3. What's 3? Oh my gosh, it's an oracle reading. Oh, me oh my, let's do this. How exciting. Woo! So I'm starting to do oracle readings in a more specific way and to actually go to markets and to offer this virtually. We're actually going to even do one once a week on Insight Timer. So this might be specific to Michaela because she's the one that picked it. However, of course, we are all mirrors to one another. And so this reading might resonate with you. So because I'm a creative wellness coach and I've created my own product and I want to blend the worlds of esoteric and practical as a life coach, my oracle readings are similar yet different. So we're going to pick 3 cards. Michaela, you'll be picking the 3 cards. And I'm just getting my themes ready. Thank you, Dana. So the way it's going to work is you're going to pick a theme of wellness. So please listen. And then I'll give you further instructions. Michaela, tell me which theme you want some insights for your oracle reading. Emotional wellness, communication wellness, financial wellness, physical wellness, nutritional wellness, vocational wellness, social wellness, environmental wellness, intellectual wellness, mental wellness, spiritual wellness, or community wellness. Hopefully I don't have to repeat which one is like boop, boop, boop. Financial wellness, it is. And this is what we're going to do. Again, it's very minimal, but powerful. Three cards. The first one, where are you? Second card, where do you want to be? Third card, what needs to happen? So let's do this. And this will be a rapid reading, right? Because we want to get to more fun. So there's black and white, and there's colored photographs that we use. And it's just more preference what you're called to. Black and white is more structural, not necessarily embodied. It's like the visioned. The colored is just more energy. So where are you, Michaela? Which deck do you want the card to be pulled from? Thank you. Tell me when to stop, Michaela. Tell me when to stop. Okay, do you want the top card, the middle card, or split the deck? Okay, I'm using Divine Feminine left hand. Here is your card. So this is where you are with financial wellness. Let's see what we see here. We see a woman laying on her back on the ground. The hair has meshed into the earth. Hands are covering eyes. There is the divine feminine abundance in the bosoms. There is a gentle smile, some ease in the mouth. There is some jewelry. So what does this all mean with financial wealth, financial wellness? Well, many things. It could be where you are is the numbers are not serving you. So you almost don't want to see. You're like, I don't want to see what's in the bank account, or I don't want to see the bills. You almost don't want to see it to believe it. You're a little overwhelmed or a lot overwhelmed. FYI, because this is community, we can also, if you see something as well, you can add it to the chat. We'll do this together. So Michaela's seeing overwhelmed. You're not really wanting to see the reality, or you're overwhelmed. Where are you with your financial wellness? You are kind of, because you're laying on your back on the earth, you're kind of at this foundational point. Maybe the abundance is not there to grow into towers or to be up and active. So financially, you're like, let me do a little less because the abundance or finances are not really there at this time. But at the same time, you're not going to completely be in shutdown because look, you're out of your house. There's ways to experience the world that don't cost money. You're still going to demonstrate elegance. There's the necklace, the bracelet, and maybe there's even ideas happening. Where are you with your financial wellness? You're dreaming, you're thinking about things. You know that you're connected abundantly to the earth. Because look, the earth and your hair are blending into one. Isn't that cool? Yeah. So I'm going to pause there because this is more of a rapid reading. So that's where you are. And yes, this reading's from Michaela. However, collectively, we might resonate with this too. Gopi resonates, mortgage stress. Jeannie wants an oracle reading. Not today, Jeannie, but I am going to do this once a week in another live. Also on Instagram, I will be looking for people for complimentary readings. So you can be in touch. Add me as one of your teachers. Bottom right corner, send me a message. It'll happen. All right. Michaela, where do you want to be with your financial wellness. Colored or black and white? Where do you want to be? Okay, Michaela, you know what to do. Tell me when to stop. Above, below, or between the sheets? Above, below, or between the sheets to make you laugh. Okay, let's use our divine masculine hand. Although I feel feminine energy is the medicine for these times, we need to balance. Here we go. So this is where you want to be. Work! Yes, so what do we have here? We have someone that is upright, facing forward, seeing the choices. Do I go there or there or there? Where do I want to be with my financial wellness? I want to wake up, leave my house, and do whatever I want to do. If I want to do that, I'll do that. If I want to do that, I'll do that. I want to have choice instead of like, oh shoot, it's beans and rice again, or going on a date in a park, not a cafe. You want to have choice and you want to have your hair down, feeling free, willing to walk and to choose with confidence. Exactly. And maybe it's the middle path. Do you see how this being is in the middle with your financial wellness? You don't want to like be completely here, completely there. You want to always decide and maybe choose the middle path. So there's saving, there's spending. And that's what I'm getting from this. Anyone else? Gopi sees the head held high. Awesome. Yeah. All right. What needs to happen, Michaela? What needs to happen? Let's find out. Where is that image coming from? Colored or black and white? Yes. Michaela likes education about finances. Well, there's lots of resources out there. Or maybe you're the one giving it. That's great. It is interesting, right? Because it's energy. There's lots to learn. I have lots to learn with also finances. Speaking of, who wants to demonstrate their finances since we're on this topic? If you'd like, you can offer a donation. All donations go towards the Wellness Oracle 2.0. We have some interns from the city's university. And it's going towards them because they're giving 250 hours this whole summer. So know that you'll help this product advance. Tell me when to stop, Michaela. This is for what needs to happen. What needs to happen? Something needs to happen for your financial wellness. Okay. Above, below, or between the sheets? Above, okay. I don't have to do anything then. What needs to happen? We have two dogs. They're my babies. That had their great continuing. Basically, you need to find Batman and Robin. Just kidding. So when there's two dogs here, they're different breeds. They're on different journeys and they are free. They're out and about. However, there is a boundary. So how would this relate, my dear Michaela, with what needs to happen? Don't isolate yourself. Talk about your finances with someone, an advisor, a friend, someone you trust that you feel is an ally, that you feel will understand where you're at. Get outside, do things within your capacity. But what's this fence? Honey, that's a boundary. So know your limit, spend within it. But for example, see how this damn fence is see-through? It's not solid. So what does that mean? You have your boundary, but dream big. Maybe you're renting. Maybe you want a house one day get a mortgage. Hold the vision. The boundary's there temporarily. Dream big. Look out and above and beyond. And you don't have to do it alone. Yes, I'm here. There's different people, communities where you can show up, get inspiration, sparks. Is this your financial advisor, parent, friend? I don't know. What happens? Brain bank, mirroring. So there's your reading, Michaela, for financial wellness, your wellness oracle reading. So what's interesting and unique about the wellness oracle and what makes Withyin and Robert Halley different, not only are we using the signature product, but look what happens. Every single exercise, every single card is linked with a holistic practice. So shall you have a longer reading when you work with me? We will actually do all of these holistic practices because maybe this is key for your alignment. If you do want these exercises, I can send it to you in the PDF format. So robert@withyin.ca to request that. I also am looking for people that want to do this on Instagram. And we're actually going to do this as its own unique live once a week. So you got palming, eye palming, take time to, you know, get rid of the stimuli and soothe those eyes. Go in the inner world for inner imaginings. You got choice. I choose I choose to make my lunch because it's healthier and I save money. And then you got the question, curiosity. What am I curious about? Curiosity is even more important than passion and purpose because it feeds the fire of what's next. Maybe the key to your financial wellness is to actually take the time. What are you curious about? Maybe it starts out as fun. Maybe it's to meet someone. Who knows where that avenue will lead and who knows what financial wellness it will bring, right? There you go, Michaela. Well, there you have it. That was our wellness oracle reading for financial wellness for Michaela. Maybe you resonated with it. All of these cards is to get outside. Do you see that? Animals are outside, woman outside, woman outside. So get outside. Please don't isolate yourself. Remember, there's so many free things you can do that don't break the budget and the wallet. Breathe in, breathe out. Oh my gosh, no donations came through on financial wellness. It's okay. Nothing expected, everything appreciated. I will take this time to share Rose, Thorn, and Seed is our Insight Timer group. So if you're not connected, please join and you can chat between the live events and share and use it as a brain bank. Maybe you're able to offer a donation or a review. It's all appreciated. Let's go. What's next? Who's next? Third person that puts an emoji and you're gonna spin. Da-da-da. Da-da-da, 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 do-do-do, do-do-do, do-do-do. You can go again if you took a breath. Why are people not excited to spin? This is the wellness wheel. A fortune! Jeannie, you are the one. And I like that you've got an evergreen tree. I can't turn my camera around, this is on my computer. But there's two large evergreen pine trees. Jeannie. Yo, G. You have G as your... Yo, G. What are we doing? Oh, sorry. Do you want to go right, left, or... Right or left? Strong, medium, or gentle? Oh, Gopi, it would never land in the middle because it's too... It'll just never land in the middle, so... Gentle to the left. I'll use the divine feminine hand. May what's highest and best come through for us all with this next experience. In 3, 2, it was gentle. You asked for gentle. We're back at the Wellness Oracle. I am going to put these cards back in. Okay, we're going to actually do the Wellness Oracle. We're going to do one exercise. Jeannie, are you called to the black and white deck or the color deck? And that's just personal preference, black and white or colored. Janine, I'm so sorry. Janine. Thank you so much. And so it is. Tell me when to stop, Janine. Breathing, trusting, highest and best coming through. For you and for me and our entire family, above, below, or between the sheets. Above, and so it is. I like finding out at the same time as you.
Rah, rah.
Awesome. So we'll do a quick photo reflection. Please observe the photograph and notice how it makes you feel. Take in the colors, the textures, the images, the shapes. What are you drawn to? How does this make you feel? What is going on? There's people outside. Somehow there's the infinity symbol. Through maybe some slow frame capture. Janine loves the image. Beautiful, because you're the one that picked it. What do you get from this? What's the story? Get outside, hang out with people, reconnect, get away from buildings, Wi-Fi, stimuli, hear the echo of the universe. Who's going camping this summer? What is the infinite part of you? Stargazing, look at all those stars. If you saw a photo of this the other day, that's pretty cool. So again, what's interesting about the Wellness Oracle is each card is a wellness practice. This is version one. This is our beta version that has the text on the side. Version two will have one sentence. But a link, a QR code that takes you to the audio and the video. So that's what we will be crowdfunding in the coming months. But let's do this practice together. Infinity. The world the world. Take two. Infinity. The word infinity comes from the Latin term infinite. Infinitus, which means unboundedness. Infinity is a concept of endless, and limitlessness wildly used in the field of mathematics and physics. The infinity symbol, which looks like a figure eight on its side, holds a deep meaning for spirituality, love, and power. It represents balance and endless possibilities. The infinity symbol can be used in cross-lateral movements where your arms and legs cross over the body's invisible center line. When both eyes, ears, hands, and feet are used equally, this can help support heightened brain function between your brain's right and left hemispheres, which allows for learning and overall coordination as a welcomed result. Get on your feet. You don't have to. You can sit down. Let's do this. Stand with your feet comfortable. Lengthen your spine and relax your shoulders. Bring awareness to your breath. Deepen your inhales and your exhales to be of equal length. Keep your inhales and exhales lengthened and equal throughout the practice. Lift both hands in front of you at shoulder height, parallel to the ground. Have a comfortable bend in your elbows and gently squeeze your shoulder blades together. So we have that natural curves in the back, heart is open. Point both of your fingers forward and curl the rest of your fingers back. So we have our pointer finger. Trace an infinity symbol in front of you with your hands side by side. Use a smooth, continuous motion towards the right and towards the left. Make sure it crosses through the body's center line. Explore your range of movement. Vary the size, the speed, and most importantly, continue tracing to infinity and beyond. We'll go for a minute. Maybe it gets into the body, into the spine, even maybe through a squat. Maybe it's more voguey. Dun, 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 dun. Breathe in, open to a cactus. Breathe out, interlace behind your back. Inhale, stretch the elbows, open the heart. Breathe out, chin down. Rock the head ear to ear. Release, intuitive movement. Awesome. My apologies to break the infinity. But yeah, who knows what was balanced consciously, subconsciously in the hemispheres, in the divine masculine, feminine, logic, reason, creativity, and compassionate dark places. Cheers. Remember to protect your peace and to hang out with those that you resonate with. at least once a week. Or you can come here, hang out with me. I'm not reading that Gopi, because I like that song too. Awesome. You're welcome, Janine. Again, I'm Robert Halley. I'm a creative wellness coach based just north of Toronto, Canada. This is the Wellness Wheel of Fortune? I don't think so. It's the Wheel of Wellness. Do you see how commercialism plants things in? Wheel of, it always has to be the Wheel of Fortune. Why can't it be the Wheel of Wellness? Well, it is. And we're doing it every Saturday. This is the only live I do on Saturdays now. I was rotating through other things, but we threw Osho on the map. So now Osho can come up if Osho wants to come up. So this is one of Withyin's signature sessions. And it's offered virtually. You know, this is one of the niche workshops. If ever you wanted to have me engage you at parties, corporate wellness, all that stuff. Let's go! Third person that picks an emoji. You're gonna spin the wellness, the wheel of wellness. I'm workshopping jingles because I don't have one yet. There's 72 people here. And Gopi, did you meticulously wait for that? Which you can, you never know, right? Someone might be blah, 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 blah. Gopi, I'm so happy you are going to spin, staying up late. And I think it's your first wellness wheel. Gopi, what are we doing? Right or left? Right or left? Strong, medium, or gentle? Awesome. We haven't gone right. Medium. Here we go. In 3, 2, may the highest and best come through. Okay. We got the oracle again, but we decided in my board members, we decided we're not going to do the same exercise. So you get to go again, Gopi. Ready? In 3, because we got the wellness oracle and we just did that. Highest and best come through. In 3, 2, 1. Oh my God, we got 3 again. Is this Jesus showing up? 33. So I have Jesus energy and 33 always shows up. Thank you, Jesus. I know you're with me and I love you too. Thanks for kissing us and our angels being here. Okay, Gopi's like, change that shit to strong. Okay, let's go strong, yo. Highest and best coming through in 3, 2. Okay, we got 2. Do we get 2? No. We got movement mirroring. Gopi, you get to tell me a song. What's a song that you're really vibing with? And we'll do some movement mirroring. I like that, actually. We've been so heady. So let's get into the body temple. What song, Gopi? If not, I'll just pick one. But we're going to do movement mirroring. So you just, you follow me. You're my mirror. Any song, Gopi, if you want it fast, medium. I know it's late for you, so maybe a ballad. Oh, you're going to make me cry. Let's do it. Let's do it. I love me some movement mirroring. Hello, welcome. I'm Robert Halley, and I'm so happy to be your guide in this musical movement mirroring experience. It'll be predominantly standing, so if you're able to stand, please do. If not, you can sit down and modify any of the movements. May you remember that meditation is many things. Could be washing the dishes. But when you're present and you're breathing, that is that focus of being here and now. And you're invited to move with me to not evaluate the images or what we're doing, but know that you can lose yourself and have a good time. Be lost in the lyrics of this classical song.
The generations, and to say we want to make it a better place for our children and our children's children, so that they know it's a better world for them, and think they can make it a better place.
There's a place in your heart, and I know that it is love. Was brighter than tomorrow. And if you really try, you'll find there's no need to cry. There's place to feel there's no further sorrow. There are ways to get there if you care enough for the living. Make a little space, make a better place. In a world with no fear, together we'll cry happy tears. So the nations turn their swords into plowshares. We can really get there if you care enough for the living. Make a little space to make a better place. Heal the world, make it a better place. For you and for me and the end.
Breathe in, breathe out. Where are you? Who are you? How are you here and now? What's a word, an image, a realization? So I realized that, first of all, I saw Janet Jackson this week. Oh, yeah. She did Scream and Michael Jackson came on, and there's no one like MJ. I had a good time with my sisters. So what I realized hearing that song is it's so easy to numb yourself to the pain of the world and just be focused on making money, surviving. So there's unmet needs to actually contribute to different nonprofits and what the earth needs. So that's what I'm getting. Yeah, I hate being busy that I'm not able to give to a cause or to help with Mother Gaia. Because even with all the suffering, there's so much beauty here. And because I'm live, I'm not letting myself have a big cry. But yeah, I love that song. Thank you, Gopi. Beautiful. Breathe in. Breathe out. Blink your eyes and mobilize. Thank you. If you're just tuning in, you can't tune in anymore, I think, because I don't think I made this a long live. So if you're here, I think if you want to stay, don't leave. We are going to be closing up soon. I think we'll do one more if it's not long. So I'm Robert Halley, creative wellness coach. I'm based north of Toronto. This is the Wellness Wheel of Fortune. Back after a hiatus. But I'm so happy to bring it back. All these wellness practices are so beautiful. So we get to do this in community, knowing that we need different things at different times. That's my mission. May we build our toolkit for self-regulation, recentering, and to take care of ourselves and each other. Thank you, Gopi. Well, if I laughed for 5.5 hours, I could cry for 5.5 hours. And I teach yin yoga in 25 minutes, so I'm not going to let myself cry. I don't know how long I'll go for. Maybe later. If we're not connected, please hit the bottom right corner. I love doing this work in community. If we're not connected, you can add me as a teacher, and then you can direct message me if you want to be an oracle reader guest. And just any general chit chat. I will be coming to New York in early July and Stratford, Connecticut in New York in mid-October. Happy to meet community members. Thank you. If donations are in your means to support the Wellness Oracle 2.0 and to pay the interns to give them an honorarium, that's where the donations are going towards. If you see value in my work and this product. Third person that puts an emoji in. Actually, let's end there, actually, so I can have a breather. This was so rich and so full. And I appreciate you. So the community care aspect is what happens when we show up together and what comes forward. Happy to be the face and the guide, but know that I'm tuned in, tapped and turned on. This goes beyond the virtual. We have people all around the world and we're doing this work together. Thank you. Godspeed, all you need, right? If you want to learn more, withyin.ca, link in my bio. Have an amazing weekend. So I'm about to do yin yoga through that platform, which is good to breathe into open parts with deep stretching. Any questions, comments? I'll do a little drawing while I check the chat. You are loved. And the Wellness Wheel's here to stay. I am going to take the first week off of the month, so literally the first 7 days of the month, 1 through 7. But please, let's stay connected, and then you'll get notifications. So the lives that I will be doing is the Wellness Wheel of Fortune. We're going to do Poetry Hour on Saturday or Sunday evening. It is tomorrow, where we write an original poem together, and you can send me your poems in the chat, and I'll read them, whether you wrote them or not. We will have movement, lyrical choreography with tantric gazing. It's very beautiful. That's Monday night. Wednesday, we have 1 minute wellness solutions with our, where are you at? 1 minute wellness from 100 wellness exercises using the die. And then we'll do a wellness oracle reading. That's all the lives about. We'll do pick different themes of life, different community members. Sound good? So again, Robert Halley, creative wellness coach, and we do things a little bit different. It's still very serious work, but let's keep the inner child alive, no matter our age. Awesome. Aw, Gopi, you're so sweet. Good to know, maybe for the future. Yeah, I'm gonna draw to breathe and just to see if there's any other things in the chat. Enjoy. Let's find some balance. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you, Tiff. And yeah, I'm always interested in knowing how you will be a gift of reciprocity to the energy that I offer and what we facilitate. So whether that's through hearts, donations, reviews, wishing each other well, may you take this into your weekend. I love you. I'm sorry. Please forgive me. Thank you. Thank you.